Listening Library presents Time Twisters, Volumes 1 and 2. Abraham Lincoln, Pro Wrestler, and Abigail Adams, Pirate of the Caribbean. By Steve Sheinkin. Read for you by Marc Thompson. Chapter 1. Miss Mabee said, "Okay, guys, let's get out our history books." The whole class groaned. Doc tilted his head back and started snoring. "Very funny," Miss Mabee said. "This is going to be fun, trust me. Abby, how about if you get us started?" Abby, she's the one who broke history. It was Abby and her stepbrother, Doc. You can thank them later. Everyone took out their textbooks. Thick books. Heavy. Kids lifted them high and let them drop onto their desks. It sounded like thunder. Ms. Mabee just shook her head. "Page 125," she said. "Today, we'll read about Abraham Lincoln." More groans. And Doc sang out, "Boring!" Ms. Mabee glared at the class. "Who said that?" Everyone knew, but no one said. "Well, whoever it was," Ms. Mabee said, looking right at Doc. "You should be aware that you are not only rude, but also totally wrong." She pointed to a poster of Abraham Lincoln taped to the classroom wall.
"Best president ever.
Honest Abe."
"Abraham Lincoln is one of our most important presidents," she said. "He basically saved the country and ended slavery. And he's certainly not boring. Come on, you'll see." And she said, "Abby, when you're ready." Abby opened the textbook to page 125. There was an old black and white picture of a house with a horse and wagon driving by. She read what it said at the top of the page.
"Lincoln, from lawyer to president."
A little louder, Abby," Ms. Mabee said. "We're going to show these people how exciting history can be." She read louder. "Abraham Lincoln sat at a large desk in his office in the city of Springfield, Illinois. He was reading a newspaper. After a little while, he put the newspaper down and stood up. He walked out of the room. He came back carrying a cup of coffee. He sat down again. He picked up the newspaper and began to read."
"Let's see what's in the old sports section today."
Abby looked up from the book, pretty confused. "See," Doc said. "Nap time." For once, Miss Mabee didn't yell at him.
Okay, she said. "That wasn't the most thrilling part, I'll admit. Doc, since you're so interested, why don't you see what comes next?"
He read aloud.
"Abraham Lincoln turned to the next page of the newspaper. He took a sip of coffee. He put his feet up on his desk. He read some more. Every few minutes, he sipped his drink."
Doc stopped.
"Do I have to keep going?"
he asked.
"No, that's fine," Miss Mabee said.
She looked at her own copy of the textbook.
"According to what it says here, he just sat at his desk all day. He read the paper, drank coffee, and, that's it. That's all he did."
"Why do we have to know this stuff?"
Doc asked.
"It's important," Ms. Mabee said.
"Why?"
"It just is," she said.
She was still looking at her book.
"This really doesn't seem right. I remember Lincoln doing a lot more. But to be totally honest, history was never my favorite subject."
"Because it's boring," Doc said.
"Well, this book is a little dry, I'll admit," Ms. Mabey said. She closed the textbook and said, "Let's do a math worksheet." And a few kids actually cheered.
Chapter 2.
When the school day ended, Abby walked through the library to the storage room in the back. It was a small room packed with books. Books on shelves, in cardboard boxes, and stacked up on the floor. There were two chairs and a table and one small window. Abby sat and started taking stuff out of her backpack.
Another boring afternoon.
This happened every day. Abby and Doc's mother was a teacher at the school and ran an after-school program for younger kids. Their dad taught at the middle school and stayed late to coach track. So every day after school, Abby and Doc had to stick around for about an hour until their mom was ready to leave. They were supposed to sit in this room and do homework or read. It was usually the longest hour of the day. Not this time. Doc came in and tossed down his backpack. He stepped onto a chair, then onto the table, and from there, he climbed onto one of the stacks of boxes. His head almost touched the ceiling. "Think I could jump from here to that big box?" He pointed to a tall box about 6 feet away.
"Probably," Abby said. "But I'm not saying you'd live."
"I'm the amazing... No! I'm Dr. Frogleg!"
"You are?"
"Well, that's my pro wrestling name," he said.
That was the big thing in school that week. There was going to be a pro wrestling tournament in the gym Friday night, and kids were joking about what their wrestler names would be.
"Watch this," Doc said.
Abby looked down at her notebook. Her mom had married Doc's dad 3 years before, so she was used to him. They mostly got along, but sometimes she felt it was best to ignore him. For example, anytime he said, "Watch this."
"I'm really gonna do it," he said.
"I'm trying to read," she said.
"Here goes," he said.
"Hold on," a voice shouted. "Don't jump on me."
Doc looked at Abby.
"That wasn't me," she said.
"Don't jump,"
the voice said again. A man's voice. Abby pointed to the big box.
Almost sounds like it was coming from...
The box shook. Something was moving around inside it. The voice said,
"It's so dark in here."
The box flaps flipped open, and the voice said,
"Ah, that's better."
Then a black hat appeared, then a head, then a chest. It was a tall man in a black suit. He had a thin, bony face and wild hair sticking out from under his hat. He looked a lot like Abraham Lincoln.
Chapter 3.
Abby stood so fast her chair fell over. Doc was frozen in pre-jump position, knees bent and arms out in front of him. The man in the box lifted a very long leg and tried to step out, but the whole thing tipped over. He tumbled to the floor with a loud thud. His tall hat went flying and a few pieces of paper fell out. Slowly, calmly, like nothing unusual was going on, the man collected the papers. He stuck them in the lining of his hat. He stood and dusted off his jacket. The guy really looked exactly like the poster of Abraham Lincoln in their classroom. Except he didn't have that beard but no mustache you always see in Lincoln pictures. He said,
"How many legs does a dog have if you call the tail a leg?"
Abby was too stunned to speak. Doc said,
five?
"No, only four," the man said, smiling. "Calling the tail a leg doesn't make it a leg."
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.